The effects we see from wildfire smoke tend to affect people who have preexisting illnesses, and in particular chronic cardiopulmonary diseases or chronic heart or lung conditions. So I did see quite a few people in my clinic who complained of worsened symptoms when smoke exposure was high. Wildfire fighters are at higher risk of exposure to much higher concentrations of smoke, obviously, and they're next in very close proximity to the source of the smoke for many hours. And unfortunately, because they're in remote areas and the temperature is very hot, they're not able to wear a lot of the personal protective equipment that could help reduce those exposures, like respirators. Preliminary studies have shown that lung function may decrease over the course of a wildfire fighting season. The symptoms that we're more worried about are symptoms like shortness of breath or wheezing or chest pressure, and those could indicate a more severe problem. And generally, again, those are people who have pre-existing respiratory conditions like asthma or chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or maybe somebody who has pre-existing cardiovascular disease. The particles we're worried about in wildfire smoke are the smallest particles that are less than 2.5 microns in diameter. Those are the particles that can travel deep within the lung and where we think that causes the most significant health effects. We recommend that people, if there is poor air quality, that they go inside and close the windows and run a personal air filter if you can. There are masks you can use to help reduce exposure. Again, they have to be very specific masks and have to be fitted to your face. And if you can't just use a bandana or just a dust mask, because that's not going to reduce the smoke in a meaningful way. In the meantime, I think taking a proactive view and trying to reduce exposures is certainly the right approach.